I'm cheap. I don't like to pay for things that I don't need. And what I don't need is a listing broker. When I sell my houses, I know how to do the paperwork. I know how to advertise. I know all that stuff. So I don't need anybody, and I know how to qualify a buyer, and I don't need any of that stuff. So what I will need the MLS. So what I have is a service that for $89, I am able to put my property into the MLS, and it's good for 6 months. I mean, this is a deal. So I don't have to pay the listing broker the 3%. I will have to pay the selling broker. So this service lets me get into the MLS, and I have to fill it out as if I were a realtor and add my pictures in and my cute little words. Sometimes after I write these words, I look back and I say, I can't believe that I did this because it's so good. But anyway, I got it done. And then I put my telephone number in there, and they call me. So when the realtor calls me, and it's my lockbox on there, so when the realtor calls me, I ask them for the MLS number, and when they give it to me, then I give them the lockbox code, and they go in and they show it. So then and then they'll either email me or, it's a lot of times they just email you a contract. And of course, then I go to town, and there's lots of things on those contracts, because I am not going to sign any contract unless I've had a chance to talk to the buyer's lender. You think I'm going to take the realtor's word that they're qualified? Not happening. I need to talk to the lender, and I'm going to ask them all the questions that I want answered, and then I'm going to make the decision of whether I think it's going to fly. Because remember, it's not necessarily it's the highest price you take. It's the one that's most likely to close. So I don't want to hear anything about stuff that has to be fixed or money they have to get for their parents or any problem. I don't want to hear problems. I want to hear either all cash or they've been totally approved, not pre-approved. That is not worth the paper it's printed on. The lender has gone through. In fact, the latest lingo is, I say, do they have desktop underwriting approval? And because the market is so good, I can say to the realtor, if they don't have desktop underwriting approval, don't even bother to send the contract. I remember when things were different, but right now there's still a shortage. So if they don't have that desktop underwriting approval, next. So hope this guy helps all this information for you, and you can learn how to do it yourself.